Mary of Bethany honored the given Jesus, and the fragrance filled the room. She honored the given Jesus, the one that was going to die and be buried. And the fragrance filled the room. To her, his selflessness was the fragrance that filled her heart. Not her little jar, and you know, and everybody's going, "Ooh, the jar, oh my God, the stuff that she gave up for Jesus. What a woman." She has none of that. This is a response to something already broken open in her heart of toward Jesus and the fragrance that he would give himself. And she's honoring him in his death and burial, in his selfless giving. So I wrote, to her, his selflessness was the fragrance that filled her heart. And probably she expected to find it already filled in the disciples' hearts. And she didn't find it there. But don't you know that she probably thought they know Jesus. They're bound to. They've been with him a long time. But see, she got a secret audience in there with Martha, and you know, she got a secret audience. Even though there might have been disciples all around, didn't mention that, but there probably were. And Martha's cooking, and she's sitting at his feet, and she's hearing something. And the scriptures don't even tell us; they only show her response. And she. I bet you anything, she fully expected this to already be in them and for them to just like go, "Oh, yes, yes, yes," to this one, this Lamb, this Spirit, be all glory, and let us break everything we got and pour it out. Instead, they didn't understand the altar of incense. They didn't understand that it was a real thing. They didn't understand that it was, you remember it says of that, it filled the place. It filled the place that he might fill all things. And to her, that fragrance was filling, she thought it was filling the place. Certainly was filling her. And then their response, you know, "Well, we could have used this for the ministry. What a waste." And Jesus says, "Let her alone. Let her alone. She did this in relationship to my burial," which means my death and I'm still waiting on the Lord to fully explain, because I said to the Lord after he shared this with me, I said, you know, you broke that for his burial. And when you buried somebody, you know, like Jesus, before they put him in the tomb, they come to bring those ointments and stuff for anybody because they would smell. Because in your death, and if it's your death, you're going to smell, and you need to be totally put away. Any fragrance of you violates the purity of Christ, or of me, it violates. And I didn't get a full picture other than she recognized the true fragrance and that he didn't need it because, number one, he wouldn't stink, and number two, he wouldn't be in there long enough. Because God honors that. What first ascended far above all powers and principalities and minds, that he might fill all things. Altar of incense. Father, we just ask you to open our eyes to Jesus and to join with him, to joyfully join with him, and to do so by the beauty of the Spirit, who also will never defile a thing. He remains hidden, invisible. He does not speak of himself. He only lifts you up, Jesus. What a pure vessel to come to us and declare you. May we not be as the disciples and totally miss an eternal moment, a precious moment. But may we be as Mary of Bethany, just doing what's in our heart, just going for it for you, Jesus. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. We're dismissed.